Hello everyone, I'm going to solve tension member problem. This is our problem, and in this case the bolting is arranged in a zigzag pattern. This is one steel member, and this steel member is connected with bolting, and this bolting is arranged in a zigzag pattern. But in my previous lecture I told you about the linear model problem. I mean the bolting is connected in linear, but in this the direction of the bolting is zigzag pattern. For this the dimensions are 160 by 8 mm, that is 160 is this distance, width of this plate, and thickness of the plate is 8 mm with the holes for 16 mm bolts, and the diameter of the bolts are 16 mm. For this we need to calculate the design tensile strength of the plate. Okay, so for this in tension members we need to calculate three types of failures are there. There are first one is yielding of gross section, and second one is rupture of critical section, and third one is block shear strength. But in this case we are not considering the block shear failure because the bolt distance, the arrangement of bolts are in very short distance. So for this arrangement the rupture failure may occurs more. So for that we are not calculating the block shear. Here we are calculating only yielding of gross section and rupture of critical section. That's why we are eliminating the block shear strength failure. Okay, so for that now we are going to solve yielding of gross section. First one is yielding of gross section. So for this code is specifying one formula, that is TDG equal to AGFY by gamma M naught. So in this the formula is specified in page number 32 in code book, page number 32. Design of tension members is section 6. The code is specifying that this formula for yielding of gross section, TDG equal to AGFY by gamma M naught. So AG is, we know that area of the gross section. For this plate area of the gross section is nothing but 160 into 8. That is mentioned in question, that is I'll show this. So area of the gross section means this is actually rectangle area is L into B, but here we are calculating the gross section area. Gross section means the depth of this plate, I mean the thickness of this plate we are considered as a width. So this is 160 into width. So 160 into 8 is a area of the this plate. So Fy is yield stress. We know that for yield stress we are using Fe415 plates. For these plates, for these steel plates, Fy value is 250, that is available in table number 1, page number 14. Fy is yield stress, that is 250. And gamma m naught is partial safety factor, which is available in table number 5, page number 30, that is 1.1 value. After calculating this, I got 290.909 kilonewtons. Okay, this is the first failure, that is yielding of gross section. And second one is rupture of critical section. We need to calculate rupture of critical section. But in this diagram, the zigzag bolting pattern he arranged in a different way. So for that, we need to calculate three types of sections. I mean, this is our diagram. This is zigzag bolting. Okay, this distance is PSA distance, that is staggered pitch distance 40 from here to here, and here to here, here to here, like that he arranged. Okay, so in this is the gauge distance, and that is G value from plate edge to this bolt center, it is 30 mm, and this bolt center to this bolt center 25 mm, like that he arranged. Okay, by using these dimensions we are going to calculate rupture of critical section. For this rupture of critical section, code is specifying the another formula that is available in page number 33, that is a TDN equal to 0.9 ANFU by gamma ml. So in this we know the Fu value. This is Fu, not Fy. Fu, that is ultimate stress of the plate. For Fe, 415 steel, and gamma ml is partial safety factor. This value is available in table number 1, and this value is available in table number 5, page number 30. but this an value we need to find out. For this, an is code is specifying one formula for an equal to net effective area. Okay, I'll show you in the code book. Yeah, this is an value, an equal to b minus ndh plus summation of psi square by 4ga. In this, because the psi is nothing but a staggered pitch, yeah, or the bolting arrangement pattern is also like this. So in this, PS value is this distance, that is 40 in the question given, that is, and g value is this distance from bolt center to this bolt center. Okay, now we are, by using these formulas, we are going to calculate an value. So an formula is, I am writing here, b minus ndh plus summation of psi squared by 4gi into thickness. So this is net effective area formula. For this, we need to calculate the net effective area for one section. In this, there are so many sections are there. First, I am going to calculate one section along section. I mean, how the rupture will occurs in different sections. I will show you in the diagram. So here, there are three sections are there. First section is linear section, that is, now the rupture occurs in this direction, this 1 1 1 1 and 1 1. First, for this section, we are going to calculate an value, I mean net effective area of the first section. So 1 1, okay. B value is, we know that width of the plate, that is 160 mm, minus n value is number of bolt holes in this section. In this sections, there are how many bolt holes are there? There are 3 bolt holes are there. We are calculating for this section. This is linear bolting, 1 2 3, and 3 bolts holes are there. So n is number of bolt holes. We are calculating 3 into dh means diameter of the bolt hole. We know in question, we know that diameter of the bolt, but not the bolt hole. But code is specifying that for the bolt hole and 16 mm diameter of the bolts we are using. For the 16 mm bolts, in table number 19, page number 73, code is specifying that for 16 mm bolts, we need to add 2 mm for diameter of the bolt hole. So that's why I am adding for 16 mm another 2 mm. So diameter of the bolt hole is 18 plus this one. But here we are calculating the linear section. Okay, there is no zigzag pattern in this section. So code is specifying that for zigzag bolting only, we need to consider this PS value. Okay, this is an PS value, and this PS is distance from here to here. But in this our section is like this. So there is no zigzag pattern in 1 1 section. That's why I am taking the PSI value is 0. 0 by anything is 0. So total 0 into thickness of the plate is 8 mm. After calculating this, I got the value, that is 848 mm square, and another 2 sections are there. Now I am going to calculate second section. So for the second section along section 1 1 2 2 1 1, here diagram is here, and our section is 1 1 2 2, next 2 2, sorry, 1 1 1 2 2 2, and 2 1 1 1. This is our section. I mean the rupture will occur like this, 1 1 1 2 2 2 2 1 1 1. For this section, now we are going to calculate an value. So an equal to, same formula I am using, 160, that is B value, width of the plate, into n, number of bolt holes in the section. I mean in this section there are 4 bolt holes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 bolt holes are there. So 4 into diameter of the bolt is 18 mm, we know that. And in this we are having the staggering. The staggering means this zigzag pattern. Okay, 1, 1. This zigzag pattern, we know that the zigzag pattern means the distance of PSI value. PSI means the distance from this bolt to this bolt center. That is 40 he given. So this is the zigzag pattern and the distance is 40. So that's why I wrote it as PSA, that is 40 by 4 into Z. Z means gauge distance. I already told that Z means from this bolt center to this bolt center, that is 25. Okay, I will show you in this code book the diagram, the same diagram. Yeah, here this is PSA and this is gauge distance. The same thing we are writing here. Okay, 25. So 4 into 25, but here we need to multiply it with this 40 PSA square. The formula is we need to multiply it with 2, because in this the staggering parts are, two parts are there, and the section is 1 1. This is linear, and the staggering is, this is one part staggering, and here linear, and this one is staggering. So 1 and 2, so that's why I multiplied with 2. So 2 into 40 square into thickness is 8 mm, thickness of the plate, that is 8 mm. So for this I got the value 960 mm square, and remaining one more section, third section is there, that is a long section. I mean, what are these three sections, sir? The rupture will going to happen in this section. Okay, so now the section I will show you. 1 1 1 1, next 2 3, next, sorry, 1 1 1 2 2 3, next 3 2 2 1 and 1 1. Okay, now the failure may occurs like this. So for that we need to calculate AN value. So AN is 160, that is B value, we know the width of the plate, and the total number of bolts are in this section. How many bolts are there? Total 5 bolts are there. 5 into 18, I'll show you in this section. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total, the section is 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1. Like this, there are 5 bolts are there, 5 into 18, plus PSA square is 40 divided by 4 into 25. In this section we multiplied with 2 because there are 2 parts in the staggering, but in this there are 4 parts in the staggering. See here, 1 2 1 2 3 2 and 3 2 another 3 and 2 1, that is 4. 1 2 3 4, there are total 4 parts are there. So 4 staggered pitch, that is into 4 into thickness of the plate, that is 8 mm. So after solving this I got the value, that is 1072 mm square. After calculating these three sections, 1 1 1 1 and second section 1 1 2 2 1 1, 1 2 3 2 1 1, I got three values. In these three values we need to take lower value, that is AN is 848, that is first section value without staggering, because the failure may occurs. Why we are considering this least value? Because the failure may occurs in the least value. I mean, the strength of that section is least. That's why we are considering this value. After that we need to find out the rupture. TDN equal to, our formula is 0.9 ANFU by gamma ML. So in this we know that AN value. AN value is the least value we are considering. 0.9 into 848 into FU, that is ultimate stress of this plate, that is 410, available in table number 1, page number 14. And gamma ML is the partial safety factor, that is 1.25, that is available in table number 5, page number 30. After this, I got the value 250.330 kilonewtons. After calculating these two values, TDN value, that is rupture of the critical section, and TDZ, that is yielding of gross section. This is 290 value and this is 250 value. After calculating these two, we need to consider the least value, because the failure may occurs in the least value. Hence the strength of the plate is least value. The least value is 250.330 kilonewtons. So this is the pattern we need to calculate the staggered pitch model. Okay, in this problem, the main important thing is we need to consider this staggering in this AN portion. Okay, in there are three different sections are there. So in these three sections, the failure may occurs due to rupture. Okay, and we are not calculating the block shear because the bolting arrangement is very nearer. So that's why we are avoiding the block shear. So here the rupturing is very more. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Bye.